Chris for BBTV. We're at Job's Gym in Newcastle, joined by Matt McCallum, the Northern Area Super Middleweight Champion. It's good to see you, Matt. Good in your hometown this time.
Yeah, good to see you, mate. Yeah, last time was in Liverpool.
In Liverpool, you were sparring with Callum Smith just before his fight, which was in Dubai, wasn't it? And I was saying then how impressed I was with your work, and I wasn't the only one. I mean, they were very impressed with your work as well, especially Buddy McGirt as well, with what you'd done. So, a great experience for you, that was, and it shown that it was, because you went on and won the Northern Area title, so congratulations as well.
Hey, thank you very much. Yeah, it was fantastic. I mean, to be asked to go and spar with Callum Smith, I think the only one that was going on one, see what I was like. I ended up being his main sparring partner. And, you know, the guy boxed, Bordelik, I think it was, French kid. Very similar style to me when I watched the fight, but yeah, great experience.
And like I said, he did well.
He was brilliant.
Yeah, absolutely.
Callum Smith, like, he in the fight, he must have just, he took the kid's power and he must have thought, I'll have him out of here within 3-4, stopping at the forefront.
He said then after the sparring, you went out with Buddy McGirt, former 2-weight world champion, legend in the game, and just tell us about that. You know, you're speaking to him, hearing the stories from him, and ultimately, you know, he was giving you some advice and feedback on how your sparring went in camp.
Yeah, we sort of, you know, we got a bit friendly with him, kept asking his back. It was the last spot, and we always went down the night before, so we'd go up, see a bit of the city, get some food, and sent to Matty. I said, shall we message Buddy, just see if he wants to come for some food. So we did, and he says, sure, man, and we picked him up from his hotel. And it was just, we were in awe. We just sat there. He was telling me about, training Mike Tyson, Roy Jones Jr., all these, you know, phenomenal names, these legends in boxing. And he knows them all. He's worked with them, trained them. He's telling him about Don King. And he said he never had any issues with him, you know. And he told loads of stories. He explained why. You know, it was a long story. I'm not going into it, but it was just interesting. You know, we lapped it all up. It was just great to hear.
He was some fighter as well, wasn't he? I mean,
phenomenal.
I've seen some of his fights. He went in with Meljic Taylor, Pernell Whitaker, and some great fights.
Yeah. Two-time world champion.
Yeah, he was. Valuable experience.
Last fight, that was more of just a tick-over fight. Boxed the lad. I had a kid coming in for a 50-50 fight, late pull-out, so I boxed Seamus Devlin again. Seamus jumped in. Tough, durable journeyman, but I'll tell you what, I should have stopped him. 6-round fight, and I think the ref knew he had a fight on Sky the weekend after. He let him spew in the corner. I'm saying, oh, ref, at least give him an 8 count. You know, it was way over 10 seconds, and I was just like, but anyway, it doesn't matter, I got the win. But Callum, obviously, winning the Northern Area title, that put us up to 15th in the country, and he just said he went on box rec. Finds it hard to find spar, and he has to sort it out now because Buddy obviously isn't from here, so he just goes on box rec, tries to find southpaws, and found me.
I mean, I was very impressed with you in your fight with Mike McGoldrick. I mean, I know Mike, he's a tough hombre as well, but I mean, that was in Bolton. He was not quite in Mike's backyard, but it was over that way. He's used to
closer
fighting,
than me.
That was on paper a real 50-50 fight. I mean, he'd probably actually step up for you, but you performed really well on the
night. Thanks, it was brilliant. Like, my best night in boxing by far. Just phenomenal, you know, the whole build up to it, the sparring 10 rounds, which I'll be doing again for this fight, you know, but everything just stepped up, the team stepped up, I stepped up, and then going down there to win the title in Bolton at the Reebok Stadium was just amazing.
This is what you've been boxing for all these nights.
It's the stuff of dreams, you know. And I'd done that. I'd only had 4 pro fights, amazing. And I took that title. I knew I could win it, you know.
That's it. 4 fights. I forgot about how many.
That was my
really fifth. When you took that on.
That was my fifth, man.
But how many had Mike had?
I think he'd had about 10. He was 9-1, I think, or 8-1, something like that. So a bit more experience. I imagine he had quite a good amateur career as well, Mike. You know, I've had no amateur fights whatsoever, 14 unlicensed. So, I know that I'm sort of, you know, surprising people all the way, and surprising myself, which is good. But I'm confident. I believe in myself. I live the life, and you'll go far, you know, with that sort of mentality and attitude.
Well, like I say, I saw them spars with Callum, and I know the reason why they keep asking you back, because it's good work, absolutely.
Yeah, it was brilliant. Yeah. Phenomenal, you know.
So tell us about this next fight now. Coming up, Mike, it's, you know, 10-rounder again.
Yeah.
You're defending your title. I mean, you've got a good opponent here. I was just talking about him. It's Boris Crichton. I mean, I've seen him fight before. Boris is a tough lad. This is a good fight for you.
Yes, yeah. I mean, he's ranked just a couple above me in on box rank, you know. These are the fights I want. Top 15, top 10 lads in Britain, you know. 10-round fight. Hopefully, you know, get the win. Well, I will get the win 100%, but it should propel us on to next year. Potential title eliminators, Commonwealth, English, stuff like that. But obviously, can't look past him. He's a tough cookie. I think his record's 9-1. He's been stopped once, and that was from Diego Costa. So, you know, he's certainly beatable. He's been down before. We'll see if he can take my power, if he can keep up with my pace and ferociousness. I actually sparred him this time last year. I've done 6 rounds. Quite interesting. I mean, you don't take much away from sparring, certainly not going into the fight, you know, but at least we've been in the ring with each other, we know a little bit about each other. It's just to see who's improved the most, you know.
Oh, yeah,
that'd
be a good fight. I was
like
that fight actually
against
Diego Costa.
Yeah, he was doing all right, and then he got caught.
Yeah,
it's all it takes in boxing, isn't it?
Yeah, this looks like a really good show, doesn't it? On the 11th,
fantastic.
You know, Matt is putting these shows on, he's got his own boxes, so you know, a lot of them are on this show, so it's good doing it together, isn't it? And fighting on the same shows together and training together, and then you know, final thing there on the night of the. You know, together, it's a nice feeling.
It's brilliant. You know, we're a proper family. We really are. Got a great stable. Really good bunch of pros here. Different weights as well. Cruiserweights, light heavies, welterweights. I'm a super middle. We've got Laura as well. You know, she's hopefully making her pro debut. So we all help each other. We all bounce off each other. And Matty, he does the full works, doesn't he? Coaches well, manages well, promotes well. So I've got nothing but love and respect from, you know, I've come on leaps and bounds since being here and being with him, you know. So long may it continue.
Matt's 31 now, so time really isn't on his hands to mess about and probably get 4 rounders here and 4 rounders there. So Matt's had to really step it up. And Matt's quite prepared to do that. He's at a level where I think he's more than capable of standing there with anybody. At super middleweight, especially in Britain, I can't say really anybody that will really fear at super middleweight for Matt. His work rates, the accumulation of punches he throws, his fitness, is phenomenal. To say he breezes 10 rounds and his 10th round is just like his first round, you know, he's still as strong in that last round, which if any fighter's got that kind of fitness and drive and still can work it with that kind of volume and not get hit in the 10th round as the first round, it's, you know, he's always going to be a tough lad to be in with. You know, and he's got an unbelievable chin, he's proved that in the past. I have been working on it since he's come with us, not to get hit as often, and it's working. So he done really well and learned a lot out the spa in Liverpool. The last time I seen you there, Chris, when he was in with Callum Smith spawn, that was invaluable for Matt. Such a good learning experience for him. And he must have done something right because Buddy was keep asking him back down to spa as well. So it's and obviously there's no better than Callum to test anybody, so you know.
And tell us about his next fight.
His next fight is against Boris Crichton on the 11th of December show at the Hilton in Gateshead. We're trying to get that for the British title eliminator, which got knocked back for that. So the board are going to look at this fight closely as well, and hopefully if Matt comes through this, then they will be looking for eliminator for his next fight. The Commonwealth as well are quite interested in Matt, and they're quite interested in making this eliminator as well. So it's it's all looking roses for him, you know, at the moment. So hopefully he can get out there on the 11th of December and get another win on his belt, and then we'll see where next year takes after that, you know.
Every show so far, I think the first show they put on was last Christmas. Boxing that was brilliant at the Hilton Hotel again, a dinner show. And since that, we've had three this year. They've all been outstanding. Yeah. They really are, just getting better and better. There's a new company as well, the promotion company, Jokes Boxing Promotions. So, you know, you have teething problems, you find your feet. Well, I feel like everything's been going brilliant. So again, mate, long may it continue.
So you're saying Newcastle boxing is thriving, and Matt is a big part of that going forward.
100%. He's going to be the main man, you know. If he's not already, he really will be, you know, because him and Phil Jeffries are good friends. But Phil, I think, wants Matty to sort of take over when he steps back. And I just want to, you know, I want to be up there on the biggest stage, you know, on Sky and BT, and I want Joe's boxing banner behind us, you know. Because I'm not just doing it for myself, I want to do it for him. Because all the hard work he's put in to help me, you know, get where I want to be.
Well, I wish you all the best. Before we go, Mike, is anyone you... tell us about your social media and any sponsors or anyone you want to thank.
Matt Stott McCallum on Instagram and Facebook. Big shout out to everyone that's helped me. I've got a few people and sponsors who've helped me. There's a few on the back. See them. Well, those people know who they are, and I love you all, man. So just keep following the journey.
Well, looking forward to seeing you next fight, mate. Awesome. Good luck and God bless you.
Cheers,
see you again.
Really appreciate it. Thank you.